Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Kính bạch Chư Tôn Thiền Đức Tăng Ni, kính thưa toàn thể quý Phật tử gần xa. Hôm nay là ngày 14 tháng 10 năm 2021, chúng ta đang có mặt trong Zoom Phật Pháp Pháp Nhãn Temple. Lời nói đầu tiên, chúng con kính lễ Đức Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni, chúng con kính lễ chánh pháp vi diệu của Đức Phật Bổn Sư, chúng con kính lễ tăng đoàn an lạc và kính chúc sức khỏe đến toàn thể đại chúng thân khỏe và tâm an trong Phật pháp. Good evening, dear Dhamma sister, brother. First of all, we would like to pay homage to the Buddha, the wonderful Dhamma of the Buddha and the harmonious Sangha. Today is on October 14, 2021. We are at in the Zoom of Buddhist study of Pháp Nhãn Temple. Today we keep learning, stepping into freedom, mindful manner, part 3, number 11, number 12. Now we would like to invite Dhamma sister and brother to listen to the sound of bell 3 times, and then we start to chanting number 1. Today we would like to invite Sister Yuthi, who have duty to chant chanting number 1 for the Sangha. Namo Buddhaya. Namo Dhammaya. Namo Sanghaya. Now we bow together. Okay, thank you, brother and sister. Now, today, we would like to invite Cô Diệu Thí to chant the chanting number 1 for the Sangha. Now I open here and I would like to invite, yes, Cô Diệu Thí. Cô mở.
Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Nam mô Bổn Sư Thích Ca Mâu Ni Phật. Nam mô Kassa Parakato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Nam mô Kassa Parakato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Nam mô Kassa Parakato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Respectfully pay homage to the Buddha, the world honored one, the world one, the exalted one, the fully awakened and enlightened one. Namo the original master Sakya Muni Buddhaya. Namo the original master Sakya Muni Buddhaya. Namo the original master Sakya Muni Buddhaya. Praising the Buddha as a wonderful as a lotus flowers, as bright as the northern star, let us come back and take refuge in the master of gods and human beings. Respectfully pay homage to the Triple Gem, the Buddha, who is the fully awakened and enlightened one, shows the way of peace for living things and living beings. Has the virtuous, good, and noble sides. The Buddha's wisdom and compassion are perfect. We disciple of Gautama Buddha wholeheartedly pay homage to the Buddha, forever present in the three lifetimes and the ten directions. The Dhamma that is the right way instructs people to escape from the realm of illusion, leads us to return to the true home in order to live a life of awakening. We disciples of Gautama Buddha wholeheartedly pay homage to the Dharma, forever present in the three lifetimes and ten directions. The Sangha that is a beautiful community in harmony struggles on the joyful path together, cultivates to be freed from affliction in order to make life beautiful. We disciples of Gautama Buddha wholeheartedly pay homage to the Sangha, forever present in the three lifetimes and ten directions. I vow my whole life to take refuge in Buddha, the one who showed me the way of loving kindness, compassion, and wisdom in my lifetime. I vow my whole life to take refuge in the Dharma, the way of practicing peace, joy, happiness, and the thing and love for the rights in the present life. I vow to of my whole life to take refuge in the Sangha, the community of cultivated people who vow to lead their lives of ethics, harmony, and awareness to themselves and to others right here and right now in the present life. In the Buddha, I vow my whole life not to take refuge in Brahma, gods, demons, and evil things. I take refuge in the Dharma. I vow my whole life not to take refuge in Brahmanism and history. I take refuge in the Sangha. I vow my whole life not to take refuge in the wrong teachers, wrong teachings, bad people, and bad environments. For honor, one happily support and accept me as a Buddha's disciple from now until my whole life. I am determined to take refuge in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha. I make the vow to learn, understand, practice, and apply the Buddha's teachings into my daily life to benefit myself and other people right here and right now in the present life. Namo Buddhaya, Namo Sangha Dhammaya, and Namo Sanghaya.
Yes, thank you, cô Dụ Thí.
Recording in progress.
For your chanting.
Yeah, Namo Di Đà.
Yeah, Namo Phật. Now we start to study. We would like to welcome Sister Hạnh Minh just come here. may I turn up your microphone and then we start study. Okay. Yes, yesterday we finished here yesterday. Right now we keep learning next paragraph. Now here, number 12. Yeah. You see, today we maybe he like this new moving for you. Okay, now today we study number 10. Studying sutra or other book. Today ago, other time he like someone who gave you that book, but today we study here and you something not clear and please put a question. If you want to study a sutra that is not being studied by the Sangha, please ask your teacher. Nếu mà you á, ở đây có thể là bạn, nhưng mà ở đây sometimes sometimes we can use we. Nếu mà chúng ta muốn mà đọc hay là học một cái bài kinh nào đó mà nó không có thuộc, không có cùng học với tăng đoàn, tức là không có bài kinh đó, nó không có học tăng đoàn không có học cái bài kinh đó đó, thì vui lòng hãy hỏi người thầy của bạn. Please ask your our teacher. So here you see here. You see here, somebody, if we study with the Sangha and the Sangha study this book, that book, step by step, easy for you to follow. For example, if we are new, novice, if we are new practitioner, if we are new brother and sister, but we want to study the Buddhist book of the Buddha teaching all the time, we don't know, many book come, we don't know. And then you should ask your Dhamma friend, Dhamma brother and sister, or ask directly your teacher. And then easy for you. For example, now which book for you first? If you want to study the Buddha teaching by reading book, maybe Pháp Thanh know. Why glow old past, right? And then this is basic for you to learn. And how about another book? It may be you have the heart of the Buddha teaching, the Buddha and his teaching. First the order. Zen Master Thích Nhất Hạnh, another book, the other, Narada. Narada, this is a wonderful book, so for you to learn. Now we study here, it's a basis, but simple basis, but meaningful and very strong Dhamma for you, stepping into Buddha. And that's why this is the key for you. Learn this book, learn this teaching means the key for you to open the door to go into the room. You see, you have the map. The map is good, very good for you to follow the map. And that's why we study one by one, slowly but very very stable. Very stably, and that's why we learn step by step. We study the book of study Buddha teaching water the plant. We don't bore the water. You see, we don't bore the water. If we bore the water, come very fast. Oh, welcome, Brother Joe. Now the Sangha listen to one sound of bell and welcome Brother Joe. You see, that's why we study together. Study the book or study the teaching of the Buddha. Don't run fast. If we study very fast, sometimes it's very not easy for us to follow step by step. That's why we study basic teaching, but very strong, enough for a new brother and sister to follow the Buddha teaching step by step. That's why we learn, and today we study which book we study. If the Sangha don't study, now please don't read. If the Sangha study, and now please read it. Again and again. That's why we studied chapter 10 here. Now, Brother Chow just come in. That's why we are here and we show you. study the sutta or other book. If you want to study a sutta that is not being studied by the Sangha, please ask your teacher. Awakening is not a matter of how many sutta you study, but it is the matter of learning, comprehending, applying, and practicing the precept. Meditative concentration and wisdom in your daily life. A few sutra like a full awareness of breathing. Now we discuss it. Cái việc mà tỉnh thức á, tức là cái việc hiểu biết, là không phải là cái vấn đề mà chúng ta đọc bao nhiêu sách, đọc bao nhiêu kinh điển, nhưng mà cái vấn đề học và đọc kinh sách á, hiểu biết nè, và ứng dụng và thực tập cái giới nè, định nè, thiền định và trí tuệ trong đời sống hàng ngày. Có nghĩa là gì? Có nghĩa là chúng ta không cần đọc bao nhiêu kinh điển, cái đó nó không quan trọng, nhưng mà quan trọng là chúng ta phải đọc, hiểu và ứng dụng cái giới định tuệ vào trong đời sống hàng ngày. Here, you see here, now it's very important for us to apply the Buddha teaching. Now daily, every day, every week, we study, we learn a lot of book, we read a lot of book, but this doesn't matter. You see, here the teaching, very very strong teaching, very powerful teaching for us to apply the Buddha teaching. Now the virtue, meditative concentration, and wisdom for us to apply the Buddha teaching. We read every book, many book, different book, but this doesn't matter. But we should practice only the way with three practice, three practices. If we say precept, meditative concentration, and wisdom, this is very strong. It's a very strong teaching for us to apply the Buddha teaching. If we read the book a lot, learn a book, learn and read book, the Buddha teaching a lot, but we don't practice three the way with three methods: virtue, meditative concentration, and wisdom. We don't practice our time, maybe we will miss trouble. That's why novice monk, monastic people, lay people who learn and practice, who learn and read a lot of book, but don't practice three methods for the virtue, meditating concentration, and wisdom. We don't apply that teaching three methods for Dhamma brother and sister to apply the Buddha teaching all the time, we will miss trouble. That's why read the book, learn the book, and we practice the ways with three methods. Virtue, concentration, meditation, and wisdom in our daily life. All the time, we are good practitioner. You see here? And here you see a few sutra, một vài bài kinh á, như là now if you are basic level, you can look the full awareness of breathing, là một vài bài kinh, cũng như là bài kinh á, là quán niệm hơi thở, full awareness of breathing. This belong to Majjhima Nikaya. And the four establishment of mindfulness, knowing the best way to live alone, and knowing the best way to cast a snake, if study carefully, can provide a firm basis. For your practice. Và bài kinh thứ hai mà mình tham khảo nữa là bài kinh 4 qua 4 cái lĩnh vực quán niệm đó. The four là bốn quán niệm, bốn cái lĩnh vực quán niệm, thân thọ, tâm pháp, thân, body is a four means the body, thân thọ, feeling, body feeling, mind and dhamma. This is our time we can say four, but this basis sutra, the basis teaching for the beginner who want to study the Buddha teaching. Và cái bài kinh thứ ba là bài kinh người biết sống một mình. Knowing the best way to live alone. This sutta also belong to Majjhima Nikaya, Digha Nikaya. Và cái bài kinh nữa là kinh biết cách tốt nhất để bắt rắn, catch a snake if you study carefully. Và những cái bài kinh đó, a few sutra can provide firm basis for your practice. Như vậy á, bốn cái bài kinh căn bản cho cái người mới thực tập. Now here we see here, if you study a few sutra first, belong to Digha Nikaya, Majjhima Nikaya, Anguttara Nikaya, Sanguttara Nikaya and Khuddaka Nikaya, this Pali language. Maybe Brother Phat Thanh now, Digha Nikaya, Majjhima Nikaya, Majjhima Nikaya. This is a long discourses and medium discourses. Sukho Hanmin learn every day. Majjhima Nikaya, Digha Nikaya. This is basic. Some sutra, four sutra here. The sutra, the four establishment of mindfulness, discover on knowing the best way to live alone. This mentioned about don't follow the past, don't lose yourself in the future. The past is no longer. The future have not yet come. Looking deeply as it is in the right here and right now. So that sutta very wonderful meaning, very practical. If you have time, study one by one for you, and now easy for you to practice the Buddha teaching. Follow the Buddha teaching. That's why we study here. Which sutra we study? If some sutta are beyond your idea, now please keep them read and waiting. And Majjhima Nikaya is meant sutta 30, around sutta number 23. It's very very wonderful sutta. The sutta discover on knowing the best way to cast a snake if study carefully. Very 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 wonderful teaching of the Buddha. If you have time and you look that sutta and you study one by one and you know. Như vậy chúng ta thấy là bốn cái bài kinh đó, quán niệm hơi thở, bài kinh đó, người biết sống một mình, cái bài kinh đó mà cái bài kinh đó là bốn phương pháp mà thực tập vững chãi là thân thọ và tâm pháp đó, thì chúng ta học những cái bài kinh đó thì chúng ta ứng dụng vào đời sống hàng ngày rất là quan trọng. Cho nên những cái bài kinh căn bản mà chúng ta học được gì á thì chúng ta có thể ứng dụng lời dạy Đức Phật vào trong đời sống hàng ngày. Đó là bài kinh nó thuộc về Theravada Sutta. Now, or we can say Southern Sutta or Bali Sutta. Bali Sutta, we can say Bali Sutta include Majjhima Digha Nikaya, Majjhima Nikaya, Anguttara Nikaya, Khuddaka Nikaya and Khuddaka Nikaya. For five sutta we can study one by one, but very long long sutta. If you have a time and you study one by one, maybe Sikho Hạnh Minh can mention some sutta in the Majjhima Nikaya for you. Now here you see here a few sutra can provide a firm basis, tức là những cái bài kinh đó nó cung cấp cái nền tảng căn bản hay là nền tảng vững chắc for your practice, cho cái sự thực tập của mình. Now, that's Pali Sutta. Now, here, Sanskrit Sutta. Sanskrit means the ancient Indian language. Mahayana Sutta, những bài kinh đại thừa hay là kinh phát triển. Like the Vajracharika Sutta. In English, Dhammakatta. Maharatnakutta Sutta is belong to this sutta, belong to Mahayana Sutta, development sutta. Avatamsaka Sutta, Saddhammabhundarika Sutta, Lotus in English, Lotus Sutta, and Vimalakirti Sutta have close connection with this sutta. This sutta means Pali Sutta. You see here in Vietnam, những cái bài kinh phát triển đó, bài kinh đại thừa đó, như là bài kinh Kim Cương, quý vị mà nắm cái tiếng Việt đó là bài kinh Kim Cương, Vajracharika là kinh Kim Cương nha quý vị ha, Maharatnakutta là bài kinh Đại Bảo Tích, bài kinh Đại Bảo Tích nha, Maharatna Kutta. If you search on Google the name of the sutta, you know more in English. Và kinh đây là kinh Lăng Già. Avatamsaka Sutta là kinh Lăng Già. Saddhammabhundarika in Vietnamese là kinh Diệu Pháp Liên Hoa. Saddham là means wonderful. Maha means ray. Saddhamma means wonderful Dhamma. Bundarika là Lotus, là kinh Hoa Sen Chánh Pháp hay là kinh Diệu Pháp Liên Hoa. Và Vimalakirti Sutta, bài kinh đây là kinh Vimalakirti in Vietnamese, somebody translate this the whole sutta in Vietnamese, những cái bài kinh này. Và tất cả những bài kinh đó nó có cái mối liên hệ rất là gần gũi với nhau. So you see here, if you finish some sutra before at that time, you have high level, high education. At that time, you can bring some sutra. You search Google. Now you have Wi-Fi, you have internet, and you search Google. At that time, you read more. But some sutra, the Lotus Sutta, Saddhammabhundarika, Diamond Sutta, at that time, very high level. Maybe master of art in Buddhist study, the second year you studied it. Finish, you graduate BA, Bachelor of Art, at that time, not yet study, only study, but the fourth year, study some distra. But the second year, the first year, the second year in Master of Art in Buddhist study, at that time you study this sutta, very high level. Now, we are baby, we study text, stepping into freedom, you know. And step by step, in near future, finish stepping into freedom, at that time we do another sutta. Basis, but very strong, very wonderful for Dhamma sister and brother to follow the Buddha teaching step by step. That's why today we only interview, and we know how, which level, high level, low level, or medium level. Other than we know, if we are baby, but we want to, if we are baby, we want to jump, maybe tired. if we have a little bit of Dhamma knowledge, and we want to hurry to study another sutra at a time, we cannot hold the Buddha teaching clearly. That's why we study, we choose, and we learn which one is for us to learn first. Now here, only interview, but you have a general idea, near future, easy for you to follow step by step. When studying a sutta, always ask yourself, What connection is there between the wonderful teaching and my daily practice? In Vietnamese, khi mà chúng ta nghiên cứu hay học một cái bài kinh nào đó, là luôn luôn lúc nào cũng hỏi về chính mình, cái gì nó liên hệ giữa cái lời dạy, giữa cái dạy lời Phật pháp đó và cái sự thực tập hàng ngày. It's very 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 interesting for us to follow. What connection is there between this one of teaching and my daily practice? You see here. You see here, when we study sutta, we learn sutta. We learn the Buddha teaching. We learn sutta, one sutta. Our time we had compare. You see, this wonderful teaching belong to our practice or not? You see, but only have Dhamma knowledge, have a lot of Dhamma knowledge, but we don't practice, maybe we will miss trouble. We will miss the difficulty. Learn a lot, our Dhamma knowledge a lot, but we don't practice. It's not practical, not available. That's why, the Buddha, the wonderful teaching of the Buddha. How can we connect into our daily life together? It's better. You see, Brother Chow. If you learn the Buddha teaching, but you don't bring your the Buddha teaching in your daily life, in your family, in your company, sometimes trouble. And the wonderful teaching is okay, good, but how can we bring the wonderful teacher into our daily life? This is the best way for us to follow. Như vậy chúng ta thấy là cái chánh pháp rất là vi diệu, nhưng mà chúng ta phải làm sao để đem cái lời dạy Đức Phật ứng dụng vào đời sống hàng ngày để cho thân tâm an lạc và làm cho mình khỏe, thân an khỏe và tâm an, và làm cho mọi người thân an. Đó là một cái người hành giả giỏi, rất là hay. You see here, wonderful teaching means the practical teaching. See, wonderful teaching means that we can bring the Buddha teaching into our daily life, our time. How can we help our body and mind more and more peaceful, more healthier and healthier, more and more healthy? You see, our time is wonderful teaching. But wonderful teaching only know, but no practice. Oh, not good. That's why we say, when we know wonderful teaching of the Buddha, we can bring that teaching to nurture our body and mind and our loved one. How can we become less and less anger? It's better. But study the Buddha teaching a lot. Wonderful teaching, very good. The Buddha teaching, very wonderful. We say like that, but. When we apply, when we face to face with our loved one or our friend, but our anger become up. Oh, trouble. That's why this is not good practitioner. You see, good practitioner understand the Buddha teaching, which are wonderful, and now we can bring the Buddha teaching into our daily life. And when we miss something, not clear, not unwholesome, but all the time with someone, but we subdue our anger. When we say somebody say something not clear to us, all the time we can say, we can practice listening, practice to speak love and speak, to say love and speak, all the time anger become revealed. But we say, oh, wonderful Dhamma of the Buddha. But our anger on way up. Sometimes you see here, we still kill a living being. We take what is not given. We commit sexual misconduct. We tell a lie. We drink alcohol every day, all the time. Wonderful Dhamma of the Buddha, no meaning. You see? That's why we study the Buddha teaching and we apply the Buddha teaching in our daily life with our practice, our daily practice all the time. This, we say, the Buddha teaching can heal our body and mind more and more peaceful and happy. And our loved one also. If we practice understand the Dharma Dhamma, the Buddha teaching more and more wonderful. Như vậy chúng ta thấy chúng ta ứng dụng lời Phật dạy vào trong đời sống hàng ngày á, thì cái lời dạy của Đức Phật á, nó mới có ý nghĩa. Chứ còn chúng ta thấy cái lời dạy Đức Phật rất là hay, rất là ý nghĩa, rất là màu nhiệm, mà chúng ta chứng nào tập đó. Ai nói gì mình giận lên, ai nói gì mình bừng bừng cái mặt lên, thì lúc đó nó rất là trở ngại. Cho nên quan trọng là mình ứng dụng và thực tập cái đời sống hàng ngày để đem lại cái lợi ích cho tự thân và cho tha nhân ngay trong cuộc sống hiện tại. Đó là cái lời dạy của chúng ta, lời dạy của Đức Phật đối với chúng ta có ý nghĩa. So here what we contemplate this sentence. What connection is there between this wonderful teaching and our daily practice? How can I apply this teaching to my daily life in order to transform my suffering and liberate myself? Yes, this is wonderful. You see here. one more time. In Vietnamese, như vậy làm thế nào mình á ứng dụng cái lời dạy Đức Phật vào trong đời sống hàng ngày để chuyển hóa khổ đau? We can say transform our anger, delusion, hatred, ignorance, violence and liberate myself. Như vậy chúng ta sẽ làm sao chúng ta chuyển hóa khổ đau, phiền não, tham sân si vân vân và làm cho chúng ta tự do. Nghĩa là gì đó? You see here? And we study the Buddha teaching all the time. You see here? And we read the Buddha teaching in our daily life all the time. Maybe last year, we didn't learn the Buddha teaching all the time. Someone say, oh, we become angry, more and more angry. You see, more and more angry. But right now we study the Buddha teaching. We are good practitioner. Now, sometimes we say something with our loved one, with our work. A worker with our relative, with our friend, but they don't have a good chance to learn the Buddha teaching step by step. But we are different. We are good practitioner who learn and study the Buddha teaching quickly, daily, and all the time. We can adjust our mind and body. Now, last year, for example, we think last year we become a lot of anger. Right now, I okay. Now you say something not clear with me. I practice my anger and I subdue or control my anger become less and less. That's all the time good. You see, and we understand all the time. Our loved one, our worker, our friend, our people who live around us, and say something not clear with us all the time. Okay, now I'm good practitioner. Oh, you say something not clear with me. I know it. Oh, I'm practice deep listening and to say love and speak. Now, do good work, do wonderful work to say with him or her. That's why. We say we think learning the Buddha teaching and apply the Buddha teaching in our daily lives are the very important part for us to follow. Như vậy chúng ta thấy chúng ta học và hiểu như vậy là đó là một cái ý nghĩa rất là chúng ta. So here transform my suffering and liberate myself. So to study a sutta is not just or not only to enjoy its mysteriousness or repeat it to order, but to sigh its penetrating light on your own practice. Oh, wonderful. You see here in Vietnamese. Để mà học cái bài kinh á, là không chỉ hiểu được cái nghĩa thâm sâu của nó. Đây là bí mật á, nghĩa thâm sâu của nó, hoặc là lặp lại cho người khác. Không những nha, mà còn á, là soi sáng cái sự hiểu biết, cái sự thực tập của chúng ta. Cái câu này rất là hay ha. This is a sentence very important for us to contemplate. You see here. Dear Dhamma sister and brother, remember, study the sutta. You see, study the sutta. It is not only for us to understand the wonderful teaching of the Buddha and to penetrate our knowledge. You see. But also to size our penetration on our daily practice. So we learn and one sutra we learn already, but this sentence mentioned about practice and learning. Practice and learning, study the one sutta and practice the Buddha teaching the same way. You see here, practice, learning, and practice the same way. Somebody say, oh, I learn a lot, but practice lower. It's not good. You see, learn a lot, practice same way. High level is okay, but learn very high, practice very low. Oh, trouble. you are good learner, good Dhamma learner, but we are not good the Dhamma practitioner all the time, not good. You see, that's why the good Dhamma learner and good Dhamma practitioner are the same level, that's better. Learn a lot but don't practice, we will miss trouble, a lot of trouble. That's why the Buddha say in the daily chanting, maybe Pháp Thanh chant every day now. In the morning, do something wholesome. In the morning, say something wholesome. In the afternoon, say something wholesome. In the evening, say something wholesome. We have a joyful day and night. And we say the second. In the morning, think about something wholesome. In the afternoon, think about something wholesome. In the evening, think about something wholesome. We have a joyful day and night. You see? And number three, in the morning, do something wholesome. In the afternoon, do something wholesome. In the evening, do something wholesome. We have a joyful day and night. We have a joyful years and life. All the time, learning, practicing the same way. Not high, not low. That's why the same level all the time. We think the Dhamma of the Buddha are effective for us to heal our anger, our delusion, our greed. That's why we learn here. We know, and we should understand the Buddha teaching. Như vậy chúng ta thấy chúng ta học Phật pháp á, chúng ta thực hành. Cái ý nghĩ, lời nói và việc làm của chúng ta vào trong đời sống hàng ngày á, là chúng ta hiểu là cái sự học và sự thực tập á, nó đi ngang với nhau và điều đặn với nhau, thì cái giá trị học Phật á, nó mới có ý nghĩa. Chúng ta hiểu được như vậy là chúng ta rất là vui khi chúng ta học Phật. As far as commentaries or the book on Buddhism, ask your teacher or elder or an elder brother or sister in the Dhamma, whether it is visible to read them. Ngay khi mà chúng ta những cái bài luận commentary, tức là những bài luận giải đó, hay là những cuốn sách cuốn sách khác đó về Phật học nha, thì hãy vui lòng hỏi thầy này của mình nè, hoặc là những cái huynh đệ của mình, an elder brother, you see, elder. Sometimes younger is okay, but who learn the Buddha teaching all the time, we ask brother and sister in the Dhamma. Whether it's e, dù đó là nó có thể cái những cuốn sách kinh đó nó có đọc nó có giá trị không, hay là nó có lợi ích cho chúng ta đọc không, visible tức là cái lời khuyên đó, nó chúng ta có nên đọc nó không, cái lời khuyên đó có nghĩa là gì đó. So here you see here, even some commentary means the sutta, somebody teacher concern sutta and they write again all the time, we can say commentary, or the book, please ask your teacher, please ask your sister and brother in the Dhamma, before we read this book, that book. Now this book suitable for me. This book is good for me to read. If my sister and brother say, okay, this is good for you. Now please enjoy reading. All the time, spend your wrong time reading one by one. We know it. And when someone who had good heart to give you Dhamma book, Dhamma Sutta, now please ask your teacher first. Now please ask your Dhamma friend first, Dhamma brother and sister first. Don't be happy. Oh, someone give me this book free. It's free. I'm very happy. I spend a lot of time reading, but Dhamma knowledge into my mind very little. Maybe sometimes misunderstanding. That's something. Now please stop. That's why brother Hilak today ago asked that I'm very happy. We are very happy. Brother Pháp Thanh said that idea good. And brother Châu few weeks ago in Garden Road. Now I would like to learn to read some book, but which one suitable for me? Oh, at that time I say, now why close and all pass for you, and the heart of the Buddha teaching for you, and if completely reading, and ask Pháp Thanh more. Như vậy chúng ta thấy là những cái cuốn sách nào mà rất là căn bản và giá trị và hữu ích thì chúng ta học và hỏi với nhau. Cô Diệu Thí, cô Từ Viên Lạc cũng vậy. Thì cô sư cô Hạnh Minh thì study the good book, the basic book, the fundamental teaching of the Buddha daily. That's why she know. Như vậy chúng ta học và chúng ta hiểu được vậy đó, chúng ta rất là vui để chúng ta theo từng bước. We always when we read some book, we always Buddha question, is it visible to read them, for us to read them, nó có hữu ích hay là giá trị cho chúng ta để đọc không. Now here, don't accumulate too many books. Remember, don't accumulate too many books. Don't make yourself into a book. I see. the two sentence here for you very clear. You see, if you are rich person, if you are rich people who have a lot of money, you buy a lot of book, a lot of sutra. Somebody come and visit you. You always say, oh, now sister, now brother, I have a lot of book. I had a book sale. I have a lot of book. Now please enjoy seeing don't dust. Other time not good. So in this teaching say, please don't accumulate a lot of book. Please don't don't make ourselves into a book. That's why you should remember. The first meaning, we have a lot of book, we introduce someone, but we never read. You see? and second, in Vietnamese, now maybe cô Dư Thí, cô Sư Cô Anh Minh, cô Từ Bê Lạc nào. In Vietnamese, đừng có làm cha ta là con mọt sắc á. Con ngọt là gì? Suam hả? Đừng có làm mình như con ngọt sắc. Cô Dư Thí có thể, cô Anh Minh có thể chuyển ngữ cái đồ đó. maybe when we have time for Dhamma discussion another time, you three sister and Siko and Min will translate that. Please don't make ourselves into a book. That's why very important for us to know it. Như vậy chúng ta hiểu rồi. Now, we read here. Learning without practicing. So, learning without practicing. Is a book sell. You see? If you practice without learning, you see here, practice without learning, you are like a person. You see here? maintain an attitude of respect. This is another idea. So here, chúng ta học mà không có thực hành á thì giống như cái kệ đường sách á, cái đẩy đường sách hay cái kệ sách vậy. Còn nếu chúng ta thực tập mà không có chúng ta thực hành mà không có học á thì chúng ta cũng giống như cái người mù quáng, người mù ấy. Now we discuss here. You see, give advice to know how to practice. You see here, we read book a lot. But we don't practice our time, we are like a bookshelf. You see? And we practice, but we don't learn. Maybe this Pháp Thanh, maybe this sentence, I would some more. You are a good reader, that's why you compare. You see, to Western, I would some more. You see here? If we practice but we don't learn, we don't find out a good teacher. You see, we are good practitioner, but we don't find out a good teacher, a good teaching. And our time we will become the person who don't practice the Buddha teaching. Our time our mind become blind. And we know here, and we learning and practicing the same level, and we are good practitioner, but only practice. For example, I give you one example very clear for you. You say, now I am meditator. You see, I am meditator. Reading the sutta, I learning the sutta. I don't care. I spend my robot time practicing meditation. It's better for me. Not enough. Somebody say, I spend a robot time reciting the name of the Buddha. Learning, I don't care. Reading, I don't care. And trouble. So that time, knowledge, Dhamma knowledge, become zero. You see, so before we practice, before we are good practitioner, you should Dhamma learner is better. Because why we say like that? Because you are good Dhamma learner, and our time you have a lot of knowledge of the Buddha teaching, and then our time you can compare which is suitable for you. How can you recite the name of the Buddha? How can you practice the Buddha teaching? How can you become a meditator? At the time, you have a lot of knowledge. At the time, you compare your practice. And near future, your student, your brother or sister will ask you some question. At the time, you say, if you are not good Dhamma learner, you say, No, Don't ask me more. Don't ask me. Should practice better. For me, practice. If you want to practice, now please follow me. But don't ask me the meaning. What is the meaning? What does it mean? Don't ask like that all the time. We are not good. You see? So here, good practitioner is the same way we are good Dhamma learner. You see? That's why we study the Sutta of the Buddha, not only one. No, we should spend a lot of time learning the Buddha teaching, different book, different Dhamma book, different Dhamma Sutta. All the time, our Dhamma knowledge open more and more. You see, but if we are saying, oh, I am only Dhamma practitioner. I don't care. I don't care learning. Reading the book, we will miss trouble. Somebody asked us about the Buddha teaching. All the time, our Dhamma knowledge become not clear. All the time, we cannot answer. That's why we have the Dhamma knowledge, a lot of knowledge. And somebody asked, all the time, we can say the Dhamma of the Buddha. Như vậy chúng ta đừng có nghĩ rằng là chúng ta là một cái hành giả giỏi mà chúng ta không có học kinh điển. Thậm chí chúng ta nói là chúng ta là người hành giả giỏi, chỉ là một người thực tập giỏi mà chúng ta không học Phật đó, thì chúng ta rất là trở ngại. Do đó chúng ta phải là một cái người học giỏi, đọc kinh sách Phật giỏi, lúc đó chúng ta mới là một cái hành giả giỏi. Mà cả cái hành giả và cái người đọc mà giỏi thì lúc đó chúng ta mới có cái kiến thức để chúng ta điều trị và thân tâm của chúng ta và những câu hỏi của người xung quanh. Now maintain an attitude of respect toward the sutta and commentary book and step. Và chúng ta hãy duy trì cái thái độ cung kính. Now an attitude respect toward sutra and commentary book. Và chúng ta hãy có một cái thái độ cung kính đối với kinh điển và sách vở, và ngay cả cái băng đĩa cũng vậy, để chúng ta phải có cái thái độ cung kính. Always hold sutra book with both hands. You see here, both hands. And put them only in the places that are clean and respected. If you see dirt on the sutta book, don't plow it up, but use a clean cloth to wipe it. Now here, và chúng ta hãy luôn luôn á cầm cái cuốn kinh hai tay, for example. The sutta here, I give you a symbol. If the sutta chanting book, the sutta you already bring this book with your both hands better. Và đừng có đặt những cái chỗ nào mà không có sạch nha quý vị. Và hãy để kinh chỗ nào mà sạch. Nếu mà chúng ta thấy bụi trên cái bài kinh đó, chúng ta đừng có dùng cái bụi ở cái miệng mà chúng ta thổi. If you see here, if we see dirt on the sutta book, chúng ta don't use our mouth to plow it up. Và chúng ta hãy dùng cái khăn sạch để chúng ta quét nó. Chúng ta thấy nè, you see here, the chant, for I give example, chanting book here, the book here. If you have the Dhamma book, sutta, if you see the dirt on the book, đông đô la đấy. Here we can use the clean clothes to wipe. It's better. we always have attitude of respect toward the book all the time, because the Buddha, the master teaches us, because in the book have the Dhamma guardian. You see, Dhamma guardian, we can say invisible Dhamma guardian. if we do if we use our minds to blow it up our time, maybe more dirty more dirty breath. That's why we don't use our mouth to do it. We should use clean clothes to wipe. Do not put anything else on the table where you leave a sutta. You see here. Và đừng có when you see a sutta book that is damaged. That is damaged. You see here. Please repeat. Don't lie down. You see, don't lie down. Sit in a slope posture. Slope. You see, slope posture. Why you listen to a tape of the Dhamma? Only listen to the tape. You see. Moreover, if we listen to directly to the teacher at the time, please don't lie down, please don't sit in a slow posture. You see? Quý vị in the enemy, và chúng ta đừng có đặt bất cứ cái gì khác ở trên cái bàn mà nơi chúng ta để cuốn kinh. Quý vị anh, tức là cái câu tiếng Việt nó là trọng kinh, kính trọng kinh như trọng Phật. Quý vị, in Vietnamese we say trọng kinh như trọng Phật, means respect the sutta, means respect the Buddha. You see? Và chúng ta xem cái kinh đó mà nó bị hư hại thì chúng ta phải phát tâm sửa nó, và đừng có nằm hoặc là ngồi có cái thái độ mà ế ỏi trong khi chúng ta lắng nghe cái băng đĩa thôi, chứ không chi mà chúng ta nghe pháp thoại nó. Quý vị ha. Now here, you see here, today we would like to respect the sutta, the Dhamma sutta, or the sutta book more and more. You see here, in Vietnamese say trọng kinh như trọng Phật, means respect the sutta, means respect the Buddha. Because in the sutta, in the chanting book, in the sutta, our time have the invisible Dhamma guardian. When we read, when we collect the wonderful Dhamma, the wonderful teaching from the book Arthama, Dhamma, invisible Dhamma guardian, they that around us protect us. That's why we always respect the Sutta, means we respect the Buddha. You see, and we understand that Arthama. Oh, now we always. But some on the table we put on the book, on the chanting book or the sutta, we don't put anything else on the book, on the table, the same. That's why we learn and we know it. Here, so we see the sutta demos. If we see the sutta, that is a demos, demos sutta. Now please use our money. To go to a printing book, printing shopping, printing store, and open our good heart to printing to print new book for the temple, for the Dhamma brother and sister. Some book very good, some book very wonderful meaning. We please open your heart, our heart, to buy to printing more and more book. To donate, to give, to donate someone, because Dhamma book, Dhamma book, a wonderful book, can help more people who will become less and less anger, suffering. That's why we some book we are good, and we would like to express our good heart to bring more book, to buy more book, to donate someone. We learn someone who want to learn the Buddha teaching. Our time we save money, volunteer to buy more book, and to give someone who want to understand the Buddha teaching more and more. You see here, and please don't lie down. please don't sit in a slow posture while we listen to the Dhamma talk. Here mention about a test, you see. somebody learn, listen to the Buddha teaching, learn the Dhamma directly with the teacher, with Dhamma brain, with the lecturer at the time. My body very tired now. I do like that. Other time we don't have a respectful attitude. You see, here mention about that DVD, YouTube, recently a long time, maybe few years ago, other time we use the tape, but right now somebody use YouTube. Somebody say, "Oh, now I'm tired." Slow posture means sometimes become our body and mind a little bit boring. This not good. That's why this teaching teaches us how do we follow and to practice. Every time we have a more and more respectful heart to learn the Buddha teaching. That's why we understand more. Sit mindfully and respectfully as you would while listening in the Dhamma hall. Do not listen to a tape of the Dhamma talk while walking or arriving here. You see here, walking or arriving is very necessary for us. Why this mention about it? Why this teaching mention about it? In Vietnamese first. Chúng ta ngồi chánh niệm và cung kính khi chúng ta có thể. Trong khi mà chúng ta ngồi trong thiền đường là chúng ta phải ngồi ngay ngắn và chúng ta phải ngồi chánh niệm và cung kính. Và chúng ta đừng có lắng nghe băng đĩa đó hay là nghe pháp đó, trong khi chúng ta đang lái xe hoặc làm việc. Now here, you see here, this sentence mentioned about when we listen to the YouTube, DVD, VCD, tape, when we driving, when we walking, we don't listen. Maybe this teaching would like to emphasize for listener who want to listen to the Buddha teaching. Because if we driving, walking, sometimes open the tape or YouTube, but another time our concentration do not focus a good idea. You see, that's why have time enjoy reading like today, and we face to face to listen to the Dhamma talk. Other time some idea good idea we can hold it, wrap it 100% perfectly. That's good. But sometimes walking and driving, open the YouTube, open the video, sometimes only 0.5% to understand, 0.5% to get it. That's why here, emphasize, if we have proper time, listen to the Buddha teaching, please every time, better. Don't spend busy time. Listen to the Dhamma talk all the time. Maybe the main idea for you to get it only half. That's why we understand step by step when we study the Buddha teaching. Như vậy chúng ta biết là khi làm việc chúng ta lái xe chúng ta đừng có nghe, bởi vì nghe thì cái ý chính chúng ta không có nắm vững. Main idea cái ý chính chúng ta sẽ giảm đi. Now refrain from reading vision. You see here. Written fiction, including adventure, detective story, on all romance, or sexually suspected novels or story. Please ask your teacher or elder brother or sister which book would be beneficial to read. It's very important for the young people in Vietnamese first. Và chúng ta tránh đọc cái tiểu thuyết nè. Cái tiểu thuyết á, nó gồm là những cái cuộc phiêu lưu nè, hay là những cái câu chuyện thám tử nè, detective story nè, và những cái kinh dị nè, những cái sách mà nó nói về kinh dị và lãng mạn, romance. Và những cái tiểu thuyết á, nó có tính cách những cái cuốn tiểu thuyết á, nó có tính cách đó là khiêu dâm, khiêu gợi, cái dâm á, dâm dục á, và những câu chuyện đó. Và hãy vui lòng hỏi bạn của mình hoặc là những cái huynh đệ cuốn sách nào mà có giá trị hay là có hữu ích cho ta để đọc. Nào, chúng ta thấy ha. Why this paragraph teaches us? Why? You see here, I give you one example. We are like baby who have the white brain. You see here, if we don't have good person who are around us to take care of us, to protect us all the time, we can enjoy anything we like, even the internet. You see here. For example, if your children, the children have a white paper, means the white blank mind. When parents who are very busy, sometimes working, earn money, go to society, earn the money, but don't have time to take care of children. You give him iPhone, iPad, even the laptop, with internet. Sometimes you think, your children, our children, very good, busy, search something violent on internet. We don't know. You see, it's very important. You see, if we are good educator, parent plays a very important role in teaching your children. You see, if you give your children, your kids, iPhone, iPad, laptop, with internet, they are busy, search something new, something on internet, but you never know. You see, and around 3 year old until 12 year old, at a time you don't have time to take care of them, at a time their mind will become mid-trouble. You see, maybe violence come to them very quickly, sexual new come to them very quickly. You see, even they play a video game violently, and violent sexual new come to them very their mind very quickly. You see, the white paper, the black porn, you see very clearly. But when the white paper become black porn, you never know. At a time, maybe when they grow up, they will become 12 years ago. 12 years, grow up more and more. At a time, you want to teach them, not easy. You see, even the novice monk also. Sorry. or we can say even the beginner also learn something, but not without step by step. You see, Aratham, many things to learn. Aratham, maybe we don't know. Something not clear, we don't know. Because we don't have a good advisor. We don't have good mentor. We don't have good Dhamma brother, sister, or teacher who allow us to take care of us. That's why here mentioned about the young people. Young people means those who study the Dhamma step by step, Arathama, know how to follow which one study first, which one learn first. So at home, here, emphasize in the family. You see, if we are we have a children, we should spend a lot of time looking after our kids. Maybe per day, at least 1 hour or 2 hours. You see, if we are busy, earn money, but your kid will become angry person, angry people, not good people. We earn money for what? You see? Như vậy chúng ta thấy hàng ngày mà chúng ta kiếm tiền, chúng ta làm gì á, cái quan trọng là chúng ta phải biết canh giữ những cái đứa trẻ, nhất là những đứa trẻ bên ngoài và những đứa trẻ trong Phật pháp vậy, mà chúng ta có thời gian thì chúng ta sẽ chăm sóc, và chúng ta biết là đừng có để cho chúng lướt internet hoặc là đọc sách. Thì chúng ta thấy trong những cuốn sách đó, nó có bạo động hận thù như chúng ta vừa thấy đó, rất là trở ngại. Chúng ta hiểu được vậy đó, thì chúng ta biết là cái nào cho trẻ em trước để đọc để hiểu, thì được như vậy thì thân tâm rất là an lạc. So if you are good, if we are good educator, playing an important role in teaching the kid, or a kid mentor, the beginner who study, which one for him or for her studies first, at our time we are good teacher, good educator to interview them, but should have time, spend a lot of time looking after their life. And then at our time, in the future, the kid go to college, like brother Hila have a kid, have one sister, have your children, have your daughter. Next year, go to the college, at our time, we feel peaceful, we feel skilled. Our time, okay, now my duty, my burden become less and less, because we are good teacher, a good educator, good parent, to teach our kids, your kids, your children. That's why in the future, and she or he become a college student, they open mind, they remember. Now our parent, my mother, my father, who are very good teacher, I would like to express deep gratitude to my parent teaching. You see, that's why here mentioned about vision include, this vision include violin book, violin new, sexual new, so we should know. Như vậy chúng ta thấy cái sự chăm sóc của mình đối với các trẻ em á, về cách mà đọc sách tiểu thuyết hay là cuốn sách này kia, chúng ta phải cẩn thận đó, để biết mà chúng ta học. Và ngay cả vấn đề chơi game cũng vậy. Now I think here I would like to mention one more thing. Game electrical game. The book okay. Now we know game. If we give the young people, the kids, the children, iPad, iPhone, laptop, but they spend their lot of time playing a violent game. Now their mind will become trouble. That's why we are good teacher, good mommy, good daddy. Spend a lot of time to look looking after our teacher, the kids, our children, Paratama, from 3 years until 12 year or 15 year, Paratama, good student, good good kids, good children, good child, good children. You see, but we don't have when they are young, we don't have time, we don't spend a lot of time looking after our kids, a lot of time the kids. Around 15 years old, they always they expect to become 17 or 19. They want to leave home. Now I have realized, all the time we never teach them something more. You see, so here, very carefully, when the kids become young, and the Dhamma sister. And my brother also the same way. You see, and when someone who are baby should take, spend a lot of time taking care of them. Don't wait, they are grow up. Now, Brother Joe, remember that. And near future, you have time to take care your kids, good kids, good children. Near future, when they will go to the college. They college student like brother Hilak. At the time, the kids always is ready related to your parent teaching. So when they finish right away, they will finish right away BA bachelor of BA right away. And at the time, they earn a lot of money. Oh, I remember my daddy, my mommy. Now I have time. Don't worry about me. You see, they always expect different to parent or to elder sister brother in their teaching. That's why we remember to learn here. Như vậy chúng ta thấy chúng ta học và chúng ta thấy là vấn đề chơi game và đọc sách mà không có người hướng dẫn đó thì rất là trở ngại. Vậy nên ở đây mà chúng ta dành thời gian mà đọc và học nghĩa rất là ý nghĩa cho chúng ta. If after studying the sutta and commentary, you still have time to read book on the history of civilization, general history, natural history, comparative reason. Now please, I want to see how many. Only one more. Nếu mà học một kinh điển và những bài luận á, những kinh sách hay những bài luận giải đó mà chúng ta có thời gian đó, chúng ta có thời gian nhiều hơn nữa đó, thì đọc những cuốn sách mà có tính cách lịch sử văn minh, văn minh lịch sử hay là những cái lịch sử về cái khái quát hay là những cái lịch sử tự nhiên hay là tôn giáo so sánh hay là so sánh tôn giáo và apply psychology or recent scientific discovery as they can help you understand the sutta and later they can help your explain the teaching in the relevant way. Và những cái cuốn sách mà tâm lý học nè, ứng dụng nè và những cái cuốn sách mà có khoa học, khám phá khoa học gần đây và chúng những cái cuốn sách đó book đó thì nó có thể giúp cho mình hiểu được kinh điển sau này và nó có thể giúp mình hiểu được cái lời dạy Đức Phật tương tự. Now here maybe this finish 11 we will study next time. I can say some a little bit other time we have time for to discuss Dhamma discussion. Now if we have time finish studying the Buddha, the Dhamma book, the chanting book. If we have time, we can read some scientific book, educational book, some book, computer book, for example. And our time, that book, we will have a secular knowledge. Secular knowledge will support our Dhamma knowledge. Our time we have more and more compare. You see. And our religious book, we study the Buddha teaching book not enough. Sometimes we spend rough time learning another religious book. All the time we have compare good comparison. Now which one right, which right correct, which right not correct, which right good for us to learn more, to read more, which why not, and we reject. So if we have more time, now please spend a rough time learning more scientific book, education book. That's why we learn today. Now we have time sometime today a little bit late. The time for us to have a Dhamma discussion. Now I would like to invite Dhamma sister and brother to share your idea. I would like to listen to you now, please. Who are first? maybe brother Joe have kids. I think about the book, and maybe you will have more idea. Now please.
I always go first. It's okay. I wrote some stuff down to talk about that resonated with me. A couple of things. There's actually two things that were touched on today that I really liked. Basically, use the teachings of the Dharma to in the aspects of your everyday life. I feel like it's so easy to get caught up in emotions to oftentimes forget about the teachings that you've been studying. And I feel like as you probably study them more and more, that'll become easier as it becomes a habit as opposed to something that you're consciously thinking about. That and then, you kind of touched on a little bit. You said in the morning say something wholesome, in the afternoon say something wholesome, in the evening say something wholesome, and do something. It reminds me of both of those things. Kind of, I feel like I can easily relate to my job just in terms of dealing with people every day. I have a thing with my employees here that I call the 10 dimes trick, and they don't know. It's not a trick, it's a technique. They don't know that I do it. But I basically, in the morning, I have 10 dimes or whatever coins I can get, 10 dimes, pennies, nickels, and I put them in one pocket. And then throughout the day, it's a conscious reminder that I need to go out and tell something. I compliment somebody on their work, like, hey, good job doing that inspection. Or, hey, man, you're really killing it today. Thanks so much for having a good attitude. And every time I say something nice, I put that dime from one pocket to the other pocket as a reminder to make sure that at the end of the day, I've given accountability with positive reinforcement, as opposed to just being me all the time. You need to do this. You need to do that. You need to do this. It when you say positive things and encourage people with positivity, you get so much better results than disappointing with anger and frustration. People don't respond to that. And there's like actual like scientific reasons as to why people don't respond to frustrating words or angry words. But I mean, oftentimes when somebody comes at you and they're angry and they're frustrated, you know, you kind of just stop listening to them because you're just so concentrated on them yelling at you. They don't get anywhere with it. So I really like that. You know, it kind of tied in with that. You know, in the morning, do something wholesome. In the afternoon, do something wholesome. In the evening, do something wholesome. Say something wholesome, or you know, all throughout the day, just to try to kind of hold yourself accountable and make sure you're spreading positivity to everybody throughout the day.
Oh. Okay, thank you, Brother Joe, for your good idea to send Sangha. Now, second brother or sister. How about brother Hila? Yeah.
All right. How's it going? studying the Dharma and practicing go hand in hand. And since I started reading the Thich Nhat Hanh book and studying Buddhism, I've actually used and applied those things in my daily life with my family, and it really does work. And instead of I've broken habits of old weight because, like, you know, I've been married a long time and
we argue about the same thing, it seems like, you know, year after year, day in and day out. So I stopped that, right? And I started concentrating on right speech and right thoughts and calming down and not getting into the same old fights anymore, right? It's really improved my relationship with my family. So you study the Dharma and you study what it has to say, like right speech, right action, right focus, and then apply it to your life, and it really does enrich your life in the here and now, and you can put it to use. So yeah, it's worked for me so far.
Okay, good. Thank you, Brother Hilak, for your sharing idea. Now, today maybe Siko Hanvin before Brother Pháp Thành. Okay, we would like to invite Sister Hanvin. Okay, happy.
Namo Buddhaya, dear Master, brother and sisters. We study stepping into the freedom level. I don't think so. It's very high because it is for the office, it's for the monk and the nuns. So I think it's not a low level because to me, you know. When I read it in Vietnamese, but now when I read it in English, it looks like the first time I know it. very good book and very high level. And when we respect the Sutta, it means we respect the Buddha because the Dharma is mean Buddha teaching is mean from his mouth, from his words. So if we respect him, it means we need to respect his teachings too. And when we arriving, never listen to the Dharma tape or listening to the music. Because it's very, make our mind not control, and driving is very dangerous. So I think it's a very good advice. And we are this book for the monk, the novice. So if we are, we use the time, we need to use the time to cultivate. So we don't use the time for useless things, and not using the internet for reading not necessary, and going out to work as a normal people. It's the wrong way. Yes. So that month. You know, sometimes when we are the monk and the nun, and we do as look like the normal people, they will look down that monk or that nun, but they don't know. But the monk, that monk and the, that nun doesn't know about it, because when we are in the monastic. Monastic life, the monk and the nun will do something different from the normal people. So I agree with Joe and Hilak. I'm the lay Buddhist, but their mind will become to be a monk later. We don't know. The last words of Buddha teaching before entering entering Nirvana, he say, because when some monk know the Buddha will enter Nirvana, it means pass away. They cry a lot and they feel very sad. And Buddha say, oh, don't be sad. If I still live, but you don't use my teaching, it means you don't practice my teaching, it means in vain. It means I live in vain. So I think now you can understand the Buddha teachings. I think it's very, very good for both of you, for Miss Yuk Thuy, for Mr. Tavila, and all of us, not the both lay Buddhists and the monk and the nun. And I think it's very, very good. If you have time, you can study Master Chung Sui has written the person who know to the best way to live along. You can understand more. Thank you so much for the understanding. Con xin phép con nói sơ cho cô Từ Bi Lạc biết cái con năm là con nói là cái thời nãy thầy nói cái là cái trình độ bước tới thảnh thơi này là trình độ thấp, nhưng mà nó là không có thấp, tại vì cái này thì là mình nghe tuy là mình tại vì cái này cho những người không người là những người tập sự là novice, tức là những người sa di ni thì con nghĩ là khi mà học cái này, tại vì con đã coi cuốn sách này tiếng Việt mà ngay cả đến giờ tiếng Anh nó thầy dạy thì con thấy con rất là mới. Và nếu mà mình đã thầy nhất là được nói là mình phải trọng kinh như trọng Phật, có nghĩa là kinh của Phật đó, tức là lời của Phật nói ra, mình kính Phật thì mình phải kính kinh, phải kính cũng phải kinh cái pháp của Phật. Và nếu mà đi làm, con nghĩ đi làm hay là đi đâu đó, mà mình lái xe đó, thì mình không có nên nghe pháp, vì nếu mà mình nghe pháp thì cũng giống như mình nghe nhạc thì nó sẽ làm chi phối đầu óc của mình, thì lái xe rất nguy hiểm. Và nếu mà chúng và có cái điều mà thầy nói là không nên cuốn sách, không nên đọc những cuốn sách mà không có cần thiết, thì con thấy là đã là người tu rồi thì không có được dùng thời gian cho những cái việc vô ích, mà sẽ biết đọc những cuốn sách không có liên quan gì đến tu hành của mình, và không có được coi cả internet, cũng không được coi hoặc là đi làm như một người bình thường. Tại vì khi mà mình vào người tu mà mình làm như người bình thường, nhiều Phật tử người ta làm thì không sao, chứ mình là người tu mà mình làm như người bình thường thì đôi khi Phật tử người ta nhìn vô người ta sẽ khinh thường mình, nhưng mà những người tu đó người ta không biết, người ta cho nghĩ là cái quyển sách dạy thì rất là hay. Và Đức Phật cũng đã nói trước khi Ngài gặp Đức Phật, nếu mà tin Ngài hoặc là thương Ngài mà có nhiều người ta nghe nhập Niết Bàn người ta khóc, thì Ngài nói là hãy lấy giới làm thầy, hoặc lấy giới làm thầy, và lấy những lời teaching, tức là những lời dạy của Ngài làm thầy. Còn nếu mà giờ Ngài có sống vào lòng mình cũng mà không có thực hành cái lời dạy của Ngài thì coi như Ngài sống cũng vô ích. Ngài có nói như vậy. Dạ.
Cảm ơn cô Hạnh Minh nhiều. Thank you so much for your sharing. Before Brother Pháp Thanh sharing your good idea, I would like to say one thing. Now, right now, Brother Pháp Thanh, Thí Lạc, and Brother Châu, who are good, deep listener. When we speak Vietnamese, other time you listen to on. So you see here, this book used for monotheist people. But the Buddha say, we had all human being had a Buddha nature. All human being had a Buddha nature. That's why right now we have time to follow and learn this book with the monitored people one by one. We learn this when we will support when the monk or the nun or near future you have the sick of enlightenment to become a novice people. All the time you know how to become a novice monk, how become a beginner, monastic beginner. That's why we learn, spend time, rough time learn first. And then you know the way, the good teaching, the way, the best way to support yourself and to support the monastic people together. That's why we learn today. Don't worry about it. On Buddha, on human being had Buddha nature. That's why we spend a rough time learning and supporting by our learning and practicing the Dhamma. Thank you. Brother Pháp Thanh.
And what really stuck out to me, and I'll make it short, is when we say that on the first paragraph of this section, it says, when studying the sutra, always ask yourself, what connection is there between these wonderful teachings and my daily practice? And I think that's a good, you know, this is something that I have to work on, not accumulating knowledge, not trying to read over my level. I tend to do it a lot. I'll get excited about a specific sutra or book, and then I'll get the book and I'll start reading and I'll go, oh, this makes no sense. So I have to always remember, okay, when reading, to read slow, find a teaching, but then don't just read through it to get through it, to say, oh, okay, I finished another book. But to take the time and say, how can I apply this in my teaching? And that is how you instill the teachings, how you train the teachings into yourself. By even if you get, here's the thing, what Tai Chung Si has been very good at sharing is if you can learn the Triple Gem, the Four Noble Truths, the Noble Eightfold Path, the very fundamental teachings of the Buddha, if you only have that, but practice them well, if you only practice, you can only, even the Buddha said, if you just, all you need from the Four Noble Truths, all you need to eliminate suffering and reach nirvana is the Noble Eightfold Path. If you can master those simple eight things, maybe not so simple, but if you can just focus on that, that's all you need. Everything else is like extra jewelry on the path, extra flowers is nice, but the simplest teachings, the most basic, are the most powerful. So I like that Thich Nhat Hanh emphasized that. Focus on what you're doing, how to apply it. If it doesn't apply, reject. If you can't apply it, practice. Practice, practice, practice. Thank you.
Thank you, Brother Pháp Thanh. That's why Brother Châu hope next year, next month, waiting for you. Want to meet you, want to meet you in person. Okay, now I would like to invite Sister Yu Thi to translate main idea from three brother in Vietnamese, not in Sanskrit. Em mời cô Yu Thi.
Nam mô Di Đà Phật. Thưa thầy, đại trước tiên là Châu có nói về cái lời dạy của Đức Phật thì chính Châu là người đã áp dụng cái lời dạy của Đức Phật vào cái đời sống hàng ngày. Thì Châu rất là thích cái kinh Hạnh Phúc, đó là cái kinh mà mình đã học hồi mấy tháng trước đó. Thì rồi Châu cũng có nói là tự khuyến khích mình áp dụng những cái lời hay, ý đẹp và cái lời tốt, những cái điều tốt bằng cách là cũng như là cho mình vài cái đồng tiền làm đệ vào trong cái túi
về cái nếu như mình làm được một điều tốt thì mình lấy cái đồng tiền nó bỏ vào cái túi khác, đó như là một cái túi cái điều để mà cũng như là khuyến khích mình làm cái điều tốt. Thì Châu có nói một lần một cái nữa là khi mà mình giận á thì mình chỉ nghe, mình chỉ muốn la hét người ta thôi chứ mình không có nghe người ta nói. Đó là một cái điều mà không nên làm. Và mình phải chịu trách nhiệm về những cái hành động của mình. Đó là những cái mà Châu nói hồi nãy. Thì về Hy Lạp thì Hy Lạp có nói là cái vấn đề mà mình học với mình thực hành là nó phải tương đối với nhau. Và Hy Lạp đã áp dụng những cái lời Phật dạy vào cái đời sống hàng ngày của mình và làm cho cái đời sống của mình, đời sống gia đình được tốt hơn. Là thứ nhất đó là không có cãi cọ lộn xộn nữa, mà tại vì cứ một việc mà mình cứ cãi cọ ở ngoài thì nó không có tốt gì hết trơn. Đó thì Hy Lạp đã áp dụng được vào cái đời sống hàng ngày của chính mình. Còn chú Pháp Thanh thì chú Pháp Thanh có nói là khi mà mình muốn học cuốn kinh thì đọc cuốn kinh nào thì mình phải tự hỏi, cũng như là hồi nãy là tại Thích Nhất Hạnh có nói là mình nên coi cái sự liên hệ giữa cái kinh đó với cái đời sống hàng ngày của mình hay không. Và nếu như mà mình học, chú Pháp Thanh cũng đọc những cái cuốn kinh những mà chú không có hiểu đó, thì chú có nói là mình nên đọc chậm lại và mình nên hiểu và áp dụng những cái điều đó cho chính mình. Thì chú có nói đến tính dự tế và phát chính đạo thì mình chú nói là giản dị nhưng mà có những cái không có giản dị như nào chơi rất là khó. Và cái đó là những cái mà được chú tên quý vị đã có phần mà. Thì con cũng xin nói một chút xíu nữa thôi là hồi nãy thành trước khi mà mình vào lớp học đó thì con có nói với đồng chí Quốc Thanh và Hy Lạp về cái vấn đề này là nhiều cái kinh điển ở trên trang web thì không biết nhiều khi nó làm cho mình bị cũng như là bị không có hiểu được cái nào tốt cái nào xấu, tại vì nó quá nhiều đi mình không có chọn được. Nhiều khi mình là người bắt đầu thì mình không biết cái nào là tốt cái nào là xấu, còn mình gom vào hết mình đọc hết thì có thể là mình đọc vào lầm vào những cái mà mình không nên đọc đó, hoặc là những cái cũng như là mình nói là tà đạo vậy đó. Thì con nghĩ cái internet đó rất là quan trọng, rất là tốt và cũng rất là xấu đó. Rồi có một cái nữa là cho hôm nay là mình cứ nói là cái Phật lời Phật dạy nó rất là đơn giản, áp dụng vào cái đời sống của mình thôi, rất là dễ dàng, nhưng mà mình áp dụng có được hay không cái đó là cái vấn đề quan trọng đó. Thành ra mình học một lần mà mình nên làm cùng với lại cái lời mình học, chứ như kiểu khi mình làm mình học một lần mình cứ làm một nẻo, thành ra nó cũng chẳng những cái gì tốt cả. Với lại con nghĩ là mình phải cần biết là những cái điều mình học như thế nào cho nó đúng, chứ còn mình phải dùng cái trí tuệ của mình xem xét là có hợp với mình hay không. Nhiều khi cái kinh của Phật dạy nhiều khi không hợp với mình, nữa tức là mình không hiểu được, thành ra mình cũng không nên tìm hiểu thêm, cũng như là mình không apply được vào mình thì mình nên bỏ đi. Thì chính Đức Phật cũng vậy, khi mà Đức Phật mà đi tu mà khổ hạnh mà không hợp với ngài cũng bỏ để ngài đi tìm cái đường khác. Thì cái đó con thấy rất là hay, rất là mình nên áp dụng được không?
Cảm ơn cô Như Thế, cô nói tiếng Mỹ đi.
Yeah. Okay, I just want to share something about the I forgot. It's similar moments. Oh, I remember now. You know, about the teaching, the Buddha teachings, you know, it's very, you know, it's very simple, you know, simple things. And we can apply to daily life. But then if we know how to apply it, you know, the good thing is good. Otherwise, you know, we you know, like the daily, we deal with people, we work with people, but then we don't apply
the Buddha teaching to the daily life is mean nothing, you know. So and then before the class, I shared information about the internet with the Chipakhan and the dad regarding the internet, too much information. So and then we don't know which one to pick, and then it's very dangerous for the beginners. You know, we don't know which one to read and which one to follow, and sometimes it's really damage to our mind. Maybe the wrong teaching or the wrong idea is going to lead us to do something not good at all for ourselves, especially for our mind. You know, so that's very important. Thank you.
Thank you, Sister Yuthi. Now, around 1 minute, 2 minutes more, we would like to invite cô Từ Vi Lạc to speak Vietnamese. 1 minute, một phút thôi, mời cô Từ Vi Lạc có cái chính gì cô chia sẻ cho đại chúng học thêm. Yeah.
To be
like
that,
you like. To be
like, to be like.
To be like, to be like. Dạ mời cô.
Con thì con ít có ý lắm, nhưng mà con thấy rằng những lời mà của Đức Phật dạy đó, thì rằng nếu mà mình đem mình áp dụng được vào đời sống hàng ngày thì rất là hay, rất là có ý nghĩa. Thì còn nếu mà mình áp dụng đúng được càng nhiều thì càng tốt, thì mình có thể chuyển hóa được khổ đau, bớt đi những cái phiền não. Nhưng mà như cô vị trí nói thì cũng khó lắm. Ví dụ như nội cái chữ ba cái là tham sân si đó, mà cũng có ba chữ đó mà rất là khó thực hành. Khi mình giận nó cũng nhiều khi kèm không nổi cái giận, là mình cũng có những cái từ những cái cử chỉ cũng không hay, những lời nói không tốt, mình cũng phải ráng tu sửa lại nhiều lắm. Nếu mà đọc sách như vậy, mình đọc mình phải hiểu, chứ không hiểu thì thôi cũng như con vẽ. Mà nãy có thầy có nói là bốn cái mấy bài kinh là như quán niệm hơi thở, rồi bài bốn lĩnh vực quán niệm thân thọ tâm pháp người ta, rồi cái cuốn kinh mà người biết sống một mình, rồi cuốn nữa là biết cách tốt nhất để bắt rắn. Con biết cái bắt rắn là có phải là bắt ba con rắn tham sân si không thầy?
Cảm ơn cô Từ Vi Lạc rất là nhiều. Cô hỏi câu mà về kinh Bát Rắn rất là hay. Trước khi mà để giải thích, cô Dư Thí nói cái ý in English cô, cái chính của cô Từ Vi Lạc là thầy giải thích cho.
She just said about the Buddha teaching. If we can apply the Buddha teaching into daily life, it's very good, you know. It should really help. And then it's going to help us to transform the suffering, you know. And then it's also, you know, anger and greedy, you know, it's really simple things to say, but then it's really difficult to practice, to apply it to daily life. And she said about the reading the book. And if you read the book, you have to understand, you know. Otherwise, it doesn't help us anything. So, we have to cultivate, you know, to apply the Buddha teaching into our life, to daily life.
Thank you. Now I answer one question for Cô Từ Vi Lạc. She asked the Sutta mentioned about the best way to catch a snake. If study very carefully, it's very interesting when we study that book, that Sutta. Now main idea. Now we learn the Buddha teaching, the Sutta. You know, Sutta means the Buddha teaching. If we learn and we cling to the Buddha teaching, we say it is number one, but we hold it in our heart. Rust is in our heart. Never teaching, never practice, never sharing. Rust time is like a bowl we carry on the shoulder. We carry on the head. You see, it's very meaningful. Now we study the Buddha teaching. We never say someone. We never practice. Only have Dhamma knowledge. You see, it's like we don't have a good method to catch a snake. If we catch a snake, we use the stick head. The stick have a tripod. Yes, our time put the net, our time net basically. You see, if learn the sutta, learn the Buddha teaching the same way. But that sutta very, very powerful, very wonderful for us to learn step by step. In the future, we will study that sutta. So Kotubila mentioned about the sutta teaches us how to know the best way to cast a snake. That sutta, we will study that near future. Study the Buddha teaching, never practice for ourselves, never bring the Buddha teaching for someone or some means we carry the bowl on the head or the shoulder. You see? And a snake also the same way. Ok, that's it. Như vậy chúng ta thấy học kinh Phật chúng ta cũng phải là thông minh. Chứ mà không thông minh cũng giống như bắt rắn mà không có phương pháp, rắn nó sẽ quay nó cắn mình lại. Cũng giống như người mà đội học mà vương vào cái phương pháp và nó là số 1 rồi, không chịu thực tập và không chia sẻ ai á, thì lúc đó chúng ta sẽ khổ thân thôi. You see here, if we don't have a good method to cut a snake can turn his head and eat and bite us. That's why we will study that sutta. Now the time is over. Thank you so much for your listening and Dhamma discussion. Now before we finish, I would like to invite Cô Dư Thí to share the sutta, the sharing the merits in Vietnamese and English. Now please, mời Cô Dư Thí, near future, Brother Châu, Brother Hy Lạc. Mời Cô Dư Thí.
Người ẩn đang tôn đức này hướng về khắp tất cả đệ tử và chúng sanh đều trọn thành Phật đạo.
Mời cô đọc tiếp.
Công đức tu tập hôm nay nguyện cầu phát giới chúng sanh muôn loài và tất cả mọi người cùng nhau thực tập con đường Thế Tôn. Sharing the merit, may the merit of cultivation today be directed towards all living things and living beings. We and human beings can realize the Buddha's way together.
Thank you, sister and brother, so much for your listening and for your Dhamma discussion today. And we are very happy to welcome all Dhamma sister and brother to join the Zoom and study together, support together, and practice the Buddha teaching and apply the Buddha teaching in our daily life. Namo Buddhaya, Namo Dhammaya, Namo Sanghaya. Thank you.